Hey everyone, this is Matt. So this is a very special Halo anniversary video. We're going to look at the brand new multiplayer maps. All this footage is my own footage. I managed to receive the game 4 days early, luckily, and we're looking at Battle Canyon, because it's a remake of Beaver Creek, one of the old maps that was in Halo 1 and Halo 2. The music you're hearing right now as well is from Approach Nirvana's new album, Subliminal Message. I'm using a few of their songs. You can see all of the information in the description below. But anyway, Halo time. So as you can see, the upgrading graphics is quite, well, awesome. It's quite clear as well, because, I mean, these are Halo Reach multiplayer maps, and when you open the box, the case of the game, you actually get a download code as well as the game that's already been on the disc as well, and you can select it from the menu. So there you go, you saw me collecting the sword there, and then up here the rocket launcher sits in a familiar, you know, not similar, but familiar place to what we're used to in this. But the one thing about these maps, as you can start to see here, is the skyboxes. All six of the maps we're looking at. We're not looking at Installation 04, which is the new firefight map. Me and Phil will cover that next week. But, I mean, in terms of graphics and how much they've managed to put into these maps, it's amazing. I feel like they're the most lively in terms of moving parts and such graphic intensive but a very good way. It's not like a cluster of just stupid things. It just works very well, and the actual art style leads itself very well into what I believe 343 are probably going to do with Halo 4 in terms of some of the foreigner architecture and things like that. I'd like to see them bring more back, but anyway, we're going to take a look at another one here. This is obviously the headlong remake called Breakneck. Now, any fan of Halo 2 will recognize this map very quickly. They've changed very little about the actual thing. They've just added details everywhere, and it looks absolutely gorgeous. It's set in a very similar time period as like ODST, because we've got the superintendent on one of the signs saying evacuate, and obviously a lot of the buildings are burning. You know, it looks better than ODST because of it's running out on Reach's engine, which is an upgraded version of what we saw used in Halo 3 and Halo 3 ODST. But it just looks absolutely amazing. It's just an outstanding looking few maps they've done here, and this one, especially because it's kind of like you got these big towering buildings, it looks really cool. I like that they've put a Banshee. I think they've moved the Banshee from behind one of the bases now up to on that bridge, just for balance issues, probably just a Slayer thing. I was playing on Slayer here, so all the things and placements and things like that, these are all just Slayer on the default versions, not the anniversary versions that there are as well. The anniversary versions are basically ones that are tweaked to be even more like the original ones. So here we go, you can see I love the little dust effects coming down from that. It looks really nice, and yeah, it just looks really nice. I think I've said that about a million times. But I've been playing a bit of the campaign of Halo Anniversary as well, and the updates there are just phenomenal as well. When you can flick through between, you know, pressing the back button, you can flick back through what it looked like 10 years ago and what it looks like today. It's just really nice. Saber Interactive have done a really nice job on the graphics there. Obviously, Saber Interactive, along with Certain Affinity, were worked with 343 Industries on this game, so it just looks really good. If people don't know, me and Phil are both massive Halo fans, and you will be seeing some co-op footage starting mid next week from us of the campaign, as well as after that we'll be playing a few rounds on Installation 04, the firefight map, which is taken directly from the level Halo, the second level in the campaign, but obviously brought over to Halo Reach's way of firefight. So here we go, it just looks gorgeous. But here we go, the skybox is just defeated by the glory that is High Moon, the remake of Hang 'Em High. The skybox in this map is insane, but more about that later. As you can see, this is a very, very good remake. I mean, it's much more aesthetically common, it has things more than Tombstone did, which was the Halo 2 remake that Certain Affinity made of this map. But this, there we go, look at that portal. It just looks amazing. We have no idea what this is, But do we need to? Do we need to be told what any of this stuff is doing? Really, it's just, you know, it's foreign attack. It's awesome. So obviously the shotgun is still up here in the side room over on the side. There is a shotgun on the other side flipped as well. This gorgeous looking hologram here with things floating around it. It just looks amazing. It looks like some sort of foreigner ship or some sort of foreigner icon. It looks amazing. And there you go again, trying to focus as much as I can on this skybox because it just looks so good. However, I think what the skybox does is it kind of subtracts from the other side of the map, which actually has some really interesting graphic style and graphic aesthetics that you don't really see, but I'll show you guys that in a few moments. But picking up the rocket launcher from on top of this pillar here, a couple of shots off. Sounds pretty good. Obviously pretty low because they've got the Approach and Nirvana music in the background, but you could hear those rocket blasts then. And then the hallways, you know, there's that cold grey metal of the foreign attack, but it still looks very good. I mean, they've managed to make that look interesting in all of the more recent Halo games. But this is the other side. I love this sand windswept look. It just fits the overall design of the map a lot more than I thought Tombstone did back on Halo 2. It just looks amazing. It just looks great. It really does. And again, that whirlwind picking up to the portal. Obviously not the great portal or whatever it's called, the one over at the Ark. But this is a great looking portal to some distant place. And this is another one here. This is Penance, the remake to Damnation. We're just flying through these maps as quickly as possible. This is going to be about 12 minutes long, a little bit longer than that, this video. So let's have a look at Penance. I mean, Damnation was a really good multiplayer map. I remember playing a lot of games, especially LAN games and things like that, and a hell of a lot of games on the PC version of the game. God, did I play a lot of that, especially Halo C, the custom edition. But yeah, Sword is now up there on top. Don't jump off like I just did, you die. Go back down a different way. Just thought I'd point that out there. Pro tip for you guys who are getting the game on Tuesday, which is when it's released. Sniper is up on this perch. There is a sniper on the opposite side as well. So I imagine some pretty heated battles going on when you're trying to cross the bridge down there where the waterfalls are. And yeah. The inside is what you'd imagine from Covenant now in Halo. It's sufficiently purple, sufficiently shiny, and sufficiently awesome. It looks very nice. And I mean, they've done a really, really good job on how good this looks. And here you were going out to these walkways again. Originally, these didn't have them there. I'm pretty sure you'd be able to remove the path in Forge, hopefully, maybe. We hope. I'll do a little rotate of my character. I forgot to put my armor on, actually, in the Battle Canyon stuff footage. But yeah, that's what I usually just wear. I'm not very high level. I played Reach for a couple of weeks when it came out, and I've just been so busy since, I just haven't really been able to return to it. But I do love Halo, and although multiplayer isn't my key thing when I play on it, it's the story and single player. I do love a bit of multiplayer every now and again, especially when you get all your friends together and you're fighting off. It's just the usual Xbox Live goodness when it's not loads of trolls or stupid kids shouting, when it's just people who know what they're doing and having fun and coordinating a really good game, which I'm sure these maps are going to have. So we're going to move on to Ridgeline. This is a remake slash inspiration. It is a remake, but it's changed around layout-wise quite a lot from Timberland on the PC. Obviously, a lot of people who play consoles and never really play games, especially Halo on the PC, wouldn't have ever seen this map. It had the Sidewinder bases either end of this very foresty, bunched-in canyon. There was like a river running down the middle of it. And that's about it. This has gone and taken that to a complete different level. The bases are still very Sidewinder inspired. They look really, really nice. But it's just humongous how much detail. But the map's massive and they've put so much detail everywhere in it. Including, obviously, the skybox, the buildings, including where the things above the bases, these big structures. They look really, really nice. And all these little foreigner outcroppings with like turrets on it. It just looks really, really nice. I mean, the count of many times I've said really, really nice in this video is like a million. But it really is. I mean, It's worth noting that everything here is obviously running the Reach engine rather than the one that they developed for the single player with Saber Interactive and people. So this is obviously Reach gameplay using the new maps and everything. But it looks very nice. That relay tower, I think it's a relay station or something, it's just huge. I would love to go there. Come on, 343, you know, Halo 4, have something like that. I would love to investigate a place like that. But alas, we'll see. This is my favourite shot that I actually recorded. It just looks really nice, and the amount of detail, and they've got the Forerunner architecture perfectly on that as well. That's pretty much exactly what Forerunner architecture should look like. It's nice to know that they're still being able to do what Bungie's been able to do all these years. Looks amazing. Very nice. Okay, so the final map. Here we go. This is Solitary. It was originally Prisoner. One of the smaller skirmish maps, you might say, from the original Halo. Great, great map. Great map. It looks very nice. Wow. It's just thinking about what this used to look like. A lot of grey, kind of grey, greeny coloured Forerunner walls. It was very dull, and now they've just managed to add so much detail. That frozen wall there is probably one of the best like points of snow and stuff like that I've seen in the Halo franchise, and because it's just frozen over and everything, it looks very nice. Outside looks like there's a blizzard going on. This is through some of the windows on one of the corridors, and you can see all these little like Forerunner things spinning, and this huge pillar that runs around the entire thing just looks absolutely amazing. And here we go, you can get a really nice view of the map here. It just looks absolutely gorgeous. Very nice. It's just so interesting to see other people than Bungie do really big Halo things like this. Obviously, a certain affinity have worked with them before in releasing maps, and there was obviously a previous map pack that didn't have Bungie, you know, employees working on it at the time. But I think out of all of the Reach maps, these have probably become my favourite now, especially some of the other stuff that we've seen today. But anyway, thanks for watching. Come back next week for more Halo Anniversary content. Goodbye!
Game over.